bad on our arrival, the un-American idols. When niggas didn't pay us, got them hanging off the Eiffel. Yeah, I'm talking business, what time is CIA? I'm talking George Tenet, I seen him the other day. He asked me about my Maybach, think he had the same. Except my tenant, and this might have been a rented. You know why people get money, don't spend it. Or maybe they get money by business. I'd rather buy any gun, chase and come get it. I know Spike Lee, the killer, but let me finish. Blame it on pigment, we live in no limits. Them blow them as a piece, and this was just a figment of my imagination.
Bubba 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 55. France is back. What's up, France? Feel free to call in, guys, if you want to discuss. The number is 929-227-4646. I don't speak French. What is VAR 83?
We are big fans. Big fans of Kanye on the show. I mean, all sorts of hip-hop, but Kanye's always good for a laugh on this show. So we got something special. Cisco was talking about this before we started, and I'm excited to hear this story. Supposedly, so Cisco, set it up before we play the audio. What exactly happened that you know, Cisco?
Here's what happened. On Friday, they unveiled a lawsuit, basically.
Okay.
They charged him with having criminal activity.
Okay.
Embezzling church funds.
Embezzling church funds.
This is in Throg's Neck in the Bronx.
All right.
He's embezzling church funds for the purposes of...
Hold on. I think that's when we should play the audio so everybody can hear. DJ Conscience is in the back. I think he's got it set up with the audio.
Yeah.
Okay. DJ Conscience, we're ready. Let's see if we can get this... Man, our show is all fucked up today. I hear nothing but
sound. I blame Jermaine not being here.
Jermaine is kind of the mascot of the show.
And he sits there. He keeps everything running smooth.
Here we go. Now we got it. Listen up.
The Bronx Neck priest accused of stealing hundreds of thousands of dollars from New York City churches has officially stepped down. A civil lawsuit filed against the father and the Archdiocese of New York accuses Father Peter McCauley of using church funds for personal use for years, buying a house in New Jersey, illegal drugs, to pay for weekly sexual favors from a man named Keith Chris.
A pause? Can we pause? Resignation.
Weekly sexual favors.
Weekly sexual thing. Like, when you listen to the story, it's like, all right, I was embezzling money to what? What did he say? Buy a house?
Bought a house.
Drugs. That's normal, right, guys? Yeah. Would you guys embezzle money to buy a house? Right.
Drugs.
Well, now you have a house to do drugs inside of. Right, guys? And then what was the third thing? Weekly sex sessions with a guy named Christ?
Well, Chris, but close enough.
It was spelled...
Maybe if you have a lisp. Chris with a list is Christ. I don't know.
I mean, what is that? Like, you know, it's like, let me embezzle. Like, I think you have to separate the funds. I think you should have some funds for the house. If you're going to embezzle the funds, use the embezzled funds for the house and for the drugs. But the sex.
The gay sex paid out of your own pocket.
Yeah, you got to pay.
Gay sex paid out of your pocket.
You're
going to steal the money. Make sure the worst thing you pay for yourself.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. I mean,
we know there's always been thieves in the temple, but let's be real. You know, there's a line. You gotta have some respect for the cloth.
Let's see. Emails to Dolan. This was 3 days ago. Do you know anything about emails to Dolan?
No.
The first one to begin with, I would like to tell you who your priest, Father McKellis.
They've been going after this guy for years.
So, Father McKellis, apparently, here he is. Well, first of all, I wish I could show the picture to the people on Periscope. This is... Am I getting the picture?
All right.
Look at that. It's straight cock. Look at that guy.
Forget it.
That is straight cock, guys.
Oh boy.
Yeah. Did you guys see that? The guy in the middle is just straight dick.
Yeah, the guy that he was
abs.
Doing, the guy that he's dick. Doing that.
What
yeah,
is wearing jail boxes? Whatever you think.
The guy who was providing him with the dick is yeah. definitely worth yeah. paying the money for.
All right, this is from one of my favorite newspapers, the New York Post. Let's read it. The scorned ex-girlfriend of an S&M master. That's the first line. I didn't even get through a sentence yet. I just said, the scorned ex-girlfriend of an S&M master to a Catholic priest went right to the top and sent Timothy Cardinal Dolan emails that were hardly suitable for church.
So this is the girlfriend
yes.
of the guy
yes.
who was doing the priest.
Laying out details of the romps that were allegedly
and that's
funded.
That's what got the action started.
Right.
Because the church parishioners have been sending emails and going to the church for years.
Right.
For years. And nothing got done in the church. It's like, they was like, look, he ain't touching no kids. We all right. Leave him be.
Right. Tatiana Gudin shared with the Post her message to the Cardinal that recounted how the Reverend Peter McKelly allegedly wore a locked Lucite chastity belt along with a dog collar during pricey sessions with his bodybuilder lover. McKelly, meanwhile, remained a pastor of St. Francis de Chantal in the Throgs Neck neighborhood of the Bronx on Friday. Here it goes. McKelly loved to enjoy $300 bottles of scotch, all on a priest's salary of $2,474.
That's a priest's salary?
Like priest's salary
yeah,
of what?
Every
weekly,
month.
Monthly?
Yeah.
That's once a month. So a priest is making, let's call it $2,500 a month.
Yeah.
$2,500 a month. Crazy. That's ridiculous.
That's crazy.
When you consider that, break it down, it's 4 weeks, that's $600 a week.
Yeah, it's not much.
This is Walmart greeters making more than priests.
Right. Jackrabbit has joined us. I thought that's a good name for a guy while we're talking about gay priests.
That's crazy.
Jackrabbit.
So this is a lawsuit. Let's stress this. This is a lawsuit. Nothing criminal has been filed yet.
Yeah. Oh, let's see. On Thursday, McKelly's parishioners filed a fire and brimstone lawsuit that claimed the pastor swiped at least $1 million in church funds so he could enjoy the favors of his $1,000 per session homosexual sex master. Sex master! Wow.
That's a title.
He sounds like a thousand per session, though?
Yeah. That's a lot.
You kind of living, bro.
I mean, he's pretty
a master.
Good.
How wrinkly is the priest?
The priest is alright for a good looking people.
I mean, you know, he's older.
Middle aged dude, he's alright.
I think if he was in your prime, you could knock it down in like 5 minutes.
Nah.
Because once, nah,
look at that.
Gotta be at least 30.
He's an older guy.
It's a minimum. It's not, what's funny is they're calling it his lover. That's not his lover. It's a client, dude. This dude is doing this for money. He's getting
Keith
paid.
Christ.
Keith Christ getting that paper.
I'm gonna need that connect soon, bro.
What do you mean you need that connect? What are you talking? Hold on. What are you talking about?
A thousand a session?
You're gonna blow some dude?
Got the body for it. The dude, wait, hold on. It was homosexual. They didn't say Keith Chris was doing it or doing anything gay. The dude's worshiping you.
Okay.
Just would like to talk to Keith Chris. I ain't say I'm gonna do nothing. I just wanna know.
The dude with Ruben's body needs every option available to get that paper.
What does this job entail? Is it just like wearing a chastity belt?
I guess you gotta
collar.
Like smack.
I wear a dog collar for $1,000.
You gotta smack him around.
I'll smack him around.
And do whatever S&M, like, you know. I don't know what S&M
is. To be fair, though, as much as Lions were making of it, it does take a heavy toll on your soul. I'm pretty sure Keith Chris, I hate to say it, I'm pretty sure on a daily basis, he's looking at, in the mirror like, yo, I wear Lucite belts, man.
It's not the fucking priest.
It's not. Yeah, dude. It's not.
Like, I'm fine with fucking priests.
That's why you get $1,000.
This is
trying to wash your soul clean.
Let's see. Hold on. There's more. Gudin, Chris' former girlfriend and confidant of 10 years. Hi, Jackrabbit.
10 years?
Yeah. That's his girl.
She knew he was doing this for 10 years.
Said she sounded the alarm about McKelly in her emails to Dolan over the summer. The first one began with, I would like to tell you who your priest, Father McKelly, really is. Keith has been Father McKelly's gay-for-pay prostitute.
Stretch that right there. Not lover. Gay-for-pay. It's his job.
More specifically, Father McKelly is Keith Chris' toilet slave. What the fuck? If you don't know what that means, Cardinal, I will break it down for you.
Oh, Lord. Yo, she went in.
Yeah.
Keith Chris uses Father McKelly as his toilet.
Okay, I got it.
And Father McKelly drinks his piss during their weekly 3-day get-togethers when they take off to Father McKelly's house in Brick, New Jersey.
Far away from
prying eyes.
To be fair, strange things have happened, but I do want to agree with you that she's hyping it.
Yeah, no, she's hyping it.
He probably doesn't piss into his mouth, you know, 3 days a week. Maybe like once
maybe
a week.
Maybe like once in a while. But here's the thing.
I mean, that can get expensive.
If you're already in, uh-huh. You're already so desensitized. Like, now you're like, I'm getting away with all this. You know, you want a brawl. I can't just be
Rubio.
Pee on me. You understand what I'm saying? Like, right. You just keep going further and further into the rabbit hole until somebody pulls you up by your ears.
But you're forgetting where the story might be complicated.
Oh, listen to this.
That means homeboy.
Listen to this.
I have told this girl, like, he's peeing in my mouth.
Yeah.
No. Homeboy is peeing in the priest's mouth.
Oh, okay. Right. Yeah. I'll pee.
Get it right. This is gay for pay.
Okay, got it.
This is a job. Yeah. You show up.
Ruben, can piss in somebody's mouth?
You want to piss in my mouth for $1,000?
I would.
I'll pee in a nigga mouth for $20.
Let's see. Okay. McKelly bought the white brick ranch house for $264,000 in embezzled cash in 2009. The house features a hot tub in the back and a statue of the Virgin Mary out front.
Damn.
Father McKelly has a full-blown dungeon in the house. Master, she said McKelly would email Christ, I can't wait to get to Jersey tonight so I can drink your piss.
He's gassing, bro.
Goody.
I know when women are mad at you and they write emails.
Yeah, what did Chris do to invoke the wrath?
And if you want to get up for 10 years and shit,
that's what I'm saying. Like, he had to do some real
shit. Oh, there's
shit.
More. We would be laying in bed together and he would say, Tatiana, I have to show you this.
Wait, she's Eastern European?
Yeah. I would be looking at those emails for sport, she said. This one is my favorite, Goudin wrote the cardinal of the following email. Master, I don't really like drinking your piss, but I do it because I know it pleases you. Wow. A reply email from a New York archdiocese lawyer confirms that Goudin's emails were received by the archdiocese. A parishioner's lawyer, Michael Dowd, said Goudin emails to Dolan and her personal recollections inform much of the lawsuit. The priest and his boy toy spent $60,000 in 2012 for illicit and prescription drugs. Their main thing when they got together, they'd start shooting up the dialed you did. I don't know what the fuck. I probably pronounced that all wrong. It's an opium. McKelly was footing the $1,000 a month rent in East Harlem. I mean, this guy did a lot of shit. He got needles, syringes.
He's living off that church money.
There was equipment at the house: dildos, whips, chains, and chaps, sex toys, chastity belt. So the chastity belt was very unique. It's also small, so when it grows, you're in pain. Wow.
This was all, this, and here's what it is. This dude is a priest, and he hates himself, and he hates all his impulses, and he tried to fix it, and he couldn't, and he got put in a position where he got some money, and he was able to indulge his darkness.
Well, supposedly, here's the sickest part of the story. The most vile, sickening part. Keith told me that McKelly, over the years, had this huge fantasy for Keith to take him to Borough Park in Brooklyn, which is a Hasidic Jewish section, and
no,
to...
No.
Ready?
No!
Stop. And to humiliate him in public in front of a pretty Jewish girl. When Keith told him, I'm Jewish, as you can imagine, McKelly's perverted efforts intensified. McKelly would sometimes wait until Goudin came home so she could see their sex play, she wrote. When I got home, they would be in bed together, naked, doing their disgusting activities. Our apartment is big, but none of the rooms have doors on them. All because he has a sick fantasy of defiling a pretty Jewish girl. He's standing on his knees. He's got his collar on. Goudin said Christ relayed of their antics. Christ would say, you make me sick. You're not worthy to drink my piss. The archdiocese said on Friday that the allegations against McKelly are under investigation. Christ and McKelly could not be reached for comment.
Yeah, I don't think you're ever going to get a comment from this priest.
I love that ending. I love that finish.
Yeah.
Like, once he found out, you know, that his girlfriend was Jewish, like that Carpenter song came on, you know? Why do birds suddenly appear?
It's out of control.
I mean, it really is. What a fucking story.
Think about that for a minute, dude. And nobody has this guy standing in the pulpit every Sunday.
He's still there.
No, he resigned. He's not
there. Oh, he's not there.
Body of Christ in you every Sunday. And there's people in the church telling, like legitimately pissed off at this, and it's going nowhere.
Right.
Think about it. It took somebody from outside the church. Here's the problem with religion. It took somebody from outside the church to get the church to believe. Everybody.
It was that Jewish girl.
Everybody in the church was like, yo, this dude's fucking up. And the church is like, yo, chill. It's all right. Have faith.
And one
non-parishioner sends an email. And that's it. It's a wrap.
We got to go get Laura high. So we're going to go on break.
What a $1 million gone, bro.
Yeah. And nobody noticed.
You don't even see that much money.
You know, it's there's a lot of money in Jesus. Listen.
And gay sex.
We'll be right back with more Grime Time right here on FLOEmpireRadio.com.
Believe that shit? 10 years.